Now I can't knock it off as easily because I'm moving that back a little bit. Because I have the front facing now. And you can see my hands. Oh, move the machine a little closer. All right. We got yarn on here, so we're going to turn this back this way. Oh, this thing sticks good to the table. It won't turn. Okay, I just need it to turn around so I can see the row counter. All right. Now I need to turn it back. These suction cups are really suctiony cuppy. Okay. And the yarn is stuck around a leg. That's not good. Like I said last video, I was thinking about starting a Discord server for my craft channel. Even though it won't be on my iPad, it'll be on there, but I could maybe take some pictures, share it to my iPad, somehow, and send them to Discord. Or videos, I don't know. The only bad thing of it being at this angle is that I can't turn the handle. So I can reach the handle. That's the problem. Okay, move the scissors and that out of the way. I need the handle to be in my proscenium to hold on to because I have to use it to turn. But it's going to be frozen this way.
I'm not sure I understand.
And these suction cups don't like staying. Or they like to stay, but they stay too hard. Alright. I guess I'm reaching over like this. You'll be seeing my arm, of course. Until I can come back around. So we're gonna go back and forth is how this goes. Back and forth. And that's how we get a thread on here. And then I'll turn it back, forth, until the thread is on here. Like this. Kind of like dental floss. Except without being in my teeth. I hate dental floss. It's the worst thing in the world. No, I don't want... Okay. There we go. It almost missed. And I didn't want it to do that. Because working with yarn is like working with dental floss. It just... Okay. The little holes here are like teeth. It's not like with my other looms where the looms... You have to use a loom hook. You have to... A loom hook would probably make things easier, but I don't. The whole point is to use the and I just hope that this flat panel turns out really cute in the end because I've worked so hard on this. will probably be a mini part series. Oops. I missed that. Okay. And we're back to the beginning, so I need to turn it. Still says one row, so we're just working on row two. It'll say I'll completed row two once I complete row two. So, all right. Let's go again. Hold that tight. Okay. All right, let's go this way. I have to go behind this time. Tilt it just a little bit so I can get back here, because oh, it's still attached. That's a good thing. I was worried that it wasn't attached anymore. go this way. I'm gonna pull it through. Just hope this yarn works well, because I am determined to use it. Tilting. Can we sit upright now? Oh. This machine is very sensitive when it comes to stuff. Okay. Oh, that's doubling it. We don't want to double that, so let's go this way. Let me know in the comments if I'm doing this wrong, because, like I said, I have never done this kind of machine before, so if there's a technique that I'm messing up on, let me know down in the comments, because I'll read them, I promise. I want to use all the pegs because I want to see how many rows I can do on all the pegs here. I guess flat panel can go all the way around because it's a flat panel, so we'll have to see. And I want to see what they can do And how many rows? I don't want to do all the way up to 100 or 900 and something rows. I just want to get enough so I can see what kind of project it'll make. I know I'll have to get more yarn soon. And it'll be the end of this video once I finish this yarn, this strand, because or this video would be hours long. So this will be like a series, I guess. There, I can hide that.
Hey, lady?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm taking off, baby. I gotta go drop some packages off for mom, go get my hair cut, and then I gotta go to the basketball game. So mom should be home, I don't know, within the next hour or so. Okay?
Alright.
So I will see you later.
Uh-huh.
Love you.
Love you. Go, Major. Did the row change? Not yet. We're almost there where it'll say row two. We'll try to do a few rows of video. So We'll do three rows at a time. So this will be, we'll try to get to row three and then we'll stop. Here. It doesn't want to stay in the hole. So once we get to row three, we will stop. We're still on row one. And I'm going to edit the video so that my dad's voice would be taken out of it. That's pulled tight. I guess you can Frenchie stitch this way. Okay. Or until we run out of yarn. That's when we'll stop, actually, when we run out of yarn. So even if I'm on a certain row, we will stop when I run out of this strand of yarn, and I'll get another strand for our next video tomorrow, maybe. All right. It still says row one, so I probably will be ending still, and it would be row one. I'm going to try and just finish up the yarn here. No visibleness of a project showing up yet, because it's pull it through. This is different than using a needle or I could have used a needle. I could have used the needle and... I might try using the needle next time and see what happens. And attach the yarn to the bottom of the needle here in this hole. It might help somewhat, maybe. It wants to pull there. Oh, my neck. Like I said, it's like flossing. I'm about to run out of the strand, so once the strand is empty, we'll probably end the video. I'm trying to move this a little closer so I can see or feel. There we go. Thing about flat panels is they don't. I should have done tube as my first attempt on this thing. But let's hope that whatever comes off this thing. Is a decent project and cute and not crappy. Yarn, so can't reach. All right. Let's see what my last row is. I'll turn this around. Oh, we made it to 6. I think that's what it says. I need to pick this up a little bit so I can see it up close. I can't have pushed a zero and not done any. I might have done six rows already by just turning this thing. But I wanted to make sure that the yarn was on here tight enough. Making sure there's there's some drop stitches here. So let's fix these. Or we could just tuck it under like this. Right. Oh. That helps a lot. You know, tucking it under like that helps a good amount here. And the yarn sits around these little... These are like the pegs that the yarn sits on, and it goes in these little holes, and nice. Some of them don't have any, but that's okay. We'll fix that issue. We can't pick those up though. Oh, it's just one. Some of them have none, but I'm trying to see what number this is on. If my niece was here, she could tell me. But I think that's six rows. So, tomorrow, we will finish, we'll do another video of me doing this project. Whatever it's going to be. I'll title the video Mystery Project, I guess, series. Because I'm not sure what it's going to be. Because I usually don't know. And then once I do, then I'll go back and recorrect the names of the titles of each of the names of the project. But... I guess I can just call it Flat Panel Part 1. But. Flat Panel Part 2. This would be Part 2. The other one was Part 1. But this was my first project on my loom machine. So. I hope that the project turns out cute. I got yarn on almost pretty much every peg. We will do more tomorrow. I'm glad you... If you have stuck around, that's great. Now I've got to get this thing free from the table. And my scissors. I'm guessing that's six or eight rows. I can't tell. No yarn hanging off yet. Thanks for joining me. Like I said, I will make another video tomorrow on this project, and I'm putting all my stuff back. back on my table here because I had to remove some of the machine can fit up here. But I don't know where my glasses went. Oh, there they are. There we go. But yeah, that's this video for this time. I hope you all enjoyed. And please give this video a like and share it.